In the past, there have been many, many, many attempts to create many different types of blockchains, and many have failed because most often they didn't build for the commons, or their use case didn't fit the type of blockchain, there wasn't enough technical expertise, or more importantly, the ecosystem wasn't big enough. Of course, there are some very big centralized ledgers or companies building centralized ledgers, and we of course have these open public variants. We have some things, some blockchains in between called hybrids. It is important to realize that if you use an open public ledger, you have the benefits of open public ledgers. If you use centralized, you have the benefits of a centralized, more efficient local ledger, but also of course the three main risk categories. Bottom line, there is not really anything new here other than that you're using a cryptographically secured database. In my opinion, the open and public character and the open source principles and the decentralization, self-sovereignty and all the aspects of reorganizing future economies with tremendous amounts of transparencies are way more interesting than increasing the profit margin of a combination of consortia or multiple entities there. But that's my opinion. I can imagine that you have a different opinion, so let me know that one. And I will gladly discuss this with you. Perhaps you can teach me a thing or two. Would love to hear from you as well there. If you want to decide, do I need a blockchain? First of all, decide what is your use case. If you want to increase your profit margin and if you don't want to share your data with the entire world, you, for example, so in other words, you're a commercial party and what you want to gain market effort, or you want to create synergy with competition and cut out the synergy and divide it with your competition, then the centralized is more interesting. If you want to go full transparent and want to build new economies and futures of the world, and you realize that most likely this is the only way to go in the very far future, but perhaps even more closer by than you actually think, you should go for the open public ones. If you're a bit hesitant, you might go for a hybrid variant. Realize though that all the aspects, all the trade-offs that goes for ledgers are still accountable in the exact same way as they go regarding picking your ledger. So do I need a blockchain? It depends on your use case. What do you want to do? Do you want to get more grip on your supply chain with your competition and you don't want to share data with the entire world? Centralize it. If you want to go fully open with your ledger and want to know what your earnings are, where the materials are from, and if you have no secrets for the world, go fully open, fully public. If you're not there yet, go for hybrid. Most importantly is to realize different blockchains, different use cases. And regarding the open and public ones, they are not very efficient, but they are very efficient on a global scale. Centralized are more efficient, but have the three main risk categories and are not very efficient on a global scale because they need to communicate with all other centralized ledgers. And of course, they are in closed off environments as discussed many times before. I will add the Antonopoulos videos, Bananas on the Blockchain. He perfectly puts it in, as only one person can tell it. Let Antonopoulos do the talk here and let the experts do the work. For me, this was basically all I have to say for now. We will discuss this later on and we will actually see you or learn you how to determine your use case, your type of blockchain, etc. by using these different flowcharts with all types of questions leading you to the final point where you want to be. Once more, open public blockchains built for the commons, centralized built for centralized entities.